Please welcome my next guest, Beverly from Rock of Love Bus and from Charm School with Ricky Lake. I know based on what I was reading from fans that that is specifically the reason they liked you. They said that you were very real. You were very like girl next door. You were very down to earth because you are sweet, but also you don't let people fuck with you. I think that was sort of like your saving grace in the whole thing. Would you agree? Right.
I would definitely agree. Yeah. I mean, the first day everybody just started riding on me and I mean, about my shoes for all things, you know, so whatever, you know, I mean, I wasn't going to take shit from anybody. I wasn't going to be the instigator, but I also wasn't going to take shit from anybody. So that was just kind of my mentality, I guess, at the time, you know.
One thing that everybody, myself included, wants to know is I've had a few girls on from your season and nobody seems to be able to remember the infamous body shot incident. All we saw was like some crazy shit was going on. All of a sudden, the camera just panned to everybody's expressions of like shock and horror. What exactly happened? Nobody seems to be able to remember.
Really? Because
everybody was wasted.
What I remember happening is Gia basically got on the bar. They had a test tube shot. Gia put it in herself and then DJ Lady Tribe took it out with her mouth. So obviously they were not going to show that on TV. So they basically did a shot.
Oh my God. That's crazy. Yeah. That's crazy.
Yeah. Yeah. It was gross and just, I don't know. I mean, that's why everybody was like, I'm sure it's why they panned to everybody with crazy reactions because we all did have extremely crazy reactions.
So did she like take her panties off or did she just like pull
them off? I don't know that she had any on or maybe she, I mean, okay, now granted, this was like 12 years ago.
Right.
I remember seeing it, but I don't know exactly how it all went down. I don't know if she took them off, she pulled them to the side, she didn't have any on. I don't know. All I know is it happened and it was gross.
I want to know if you end up with like an infection or something, how do you explain that to your gynecologist?
That would be a really weird story. Kind of like the guys going like, I don't know how this gerbil got up there. It's weird.
Exactly. Yeah. How do you explain it? So you were on the bus with Cammy and Ashley, right?
Yeah.
So what the heck happened that we didn't see that made it so that Cammy just decided to go home?
So that was, I think that was after the body painting thing and Brett invited the three of us onto the bus, I believe. I don't know that I can really talk about everything that happened on the bus.
Well, Ashley admitted that she hooked up with Brett at some point.
So then, yeah. So yeah, we all ended up, he had him turn the cameras off, which never happened. Like only time the cameras were ever off was if we were all sleeping and we were quiet. If we started whispering, they came back in, mic'd us up, brought the cameras back in. So, I mean, we were always on camera, even if we were in the bathroom. So that particular time, Brett didn't allow the cameras in. We went into the bedroom of his bus, shut the door. And yeah, he very much hooked up with Ashley. Cammy was kind of on the side and I was kind of standing there like, what am I here?
Oh, that's insane. Was it supposed to be like a threesome or a foursome kind of situation?
I don't know what it was supposed to be. I know it was weird. Ashley was into it. I mean, Ashley loved it. Ashley was great, you know? And I don't know. It was a weird situation. And like I said, like I was in a relationship before I even started the whole thing. So being in that situation weirded me out, first of all, because, you know, I was worried about, I had more feelings about the relationship that I was in than Brett at that time, because I'd known him for like 5 days, you know? Mm-hmm. So it was a weird situation. Why Cammy just freaked out and wanted to go home. I mean, I guess it was just too much for her. That's all I know is that it was too much for Cammy. She didn't want to deal with that, although she seemed kind of into it when she was in the room.
Yeah.
But, you know, wow. But then I guess decided she didn't want to go down that road.
Wow, that is so crazy. Yeah, because it's interesting to me that the producers let her go.
I know she had some personal stuff that had happened before, so maybe some of that was coming up. None of us really ever found out why she totally left, because, you know, once somebody decides to leave, they're gone. Like, we don't see them again.
Right. You know? Yeah. I want to talk about Charm School for a minute. Was there more to the story of what got you so worked up with Brittany Starr?
Absolutely. Yes. So, well, first of all, Brittany Starr is insane. Everybody knew that on the show. I think once everybody saw that she was stealing everybody's dirty socks, they realized that. So, On the bus, there were these like condo bunks and then regular bunks. So basically when we first got on the buses, it was first come, first serve. So I was not one of the ones who got there fast enough to get one of the condo bunks, which are just much bigger. So basically as people would get eliminated, we were kind of in line to get the nicer bunks. So somebody had gotten eliminated. I don't remember. And it was my turn to get one of the condo bunks. Well, then Brittany Starr got kicked off of the pink bus because none of them could stand her. So they kicked her off. Nobody wanted her in the hotel where we were in. So she went to stay on the bus and she went and got into my new bed on the blue bus. So anyway, so somebody told me, well, Brittany just took your bed, blah, blah, blah. So I went in there and I'm like, what are you doing? Like, this is a thing. We've all worked it out. Like, we're in line for this. No, it's my bed. Anyway, so we started getting into it about that. Well, then she starts bringing my kids into it and she starts saying, well, you know, you're a mother. How can you even be here? What are you even doing here? Like, just really trying to think about that. Oh yeah. And that did not sit well with me at all. So we really, and I'm actually kind of surprised they didn't air it because I mean, we were in each other's face. I was fuming mad and she just kept going on about how she couldn't imagine how anybody who had children could do anything like this. And I'm like, what, who are you? Like, who are you? You don't know me, any of that, you know? So at that point, we didn't get into like any kind of fist fight then. We were just like in the aisle of the bus, just screaming at each other kind of. So she laid back in the bed. I crumbled up cookies and threw them on her and said, how do you like cookie crumbs in the bed? But anyway, so she got eliminated that night. Which I was pretty sure was going to happen, which I told her. I said, well, don't worry, you're going to get eliminated and I'll have my bed anyway. She did. She got eliminated. And I never saw her again until the first day of charm school.
Oh, wow.
So all of that kind of pent up, her bringing my children into it, her saying the things she said. I mean, I was really, really unhappy with her. And I didn't even know she was going to be on charm school. So I didn't know until like we literally got into the house and then she was there. And that was the first time I saw her since that time.
Oh, wow.
So that's why people don't understand like why I was so, so irritated
with
her.
It was pent up.
Yeah, it was very pent up. Very pent up.
If you enjoyed this, then be sure to catch the full interview with Beverly from Rock of Love Bus on Monday, April 26th, episode number 60. Only on Talk of Love. Visit youtube.com/talkoflove.